Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us discuss about the Dutasteride. What is this drug? Dutasteride is one of the drug which is used in the treatment of benign prostatic hyperplasia, which is commonly known as BPH. This is one of the disorder which results in the prostate enlargement. Under normal size of the prostate gland, the urinary flow is normal through the urethra. But when this prostate gland is going to be enlarged, it results in the constriction of the urethra, which results in the decreased urinary flow. So prostate enlargement may result in the decreased urinary flow as well as increased urinary frequency, because the bladder is going to be filled with the urine, but patients are unable to empty the bladder. So decrease in the urinary flow and increase in the urinary frequency are the two important symptoms in the benign prostatic hyperplasia, which results in the incomplete emptying of the bladder in the patients. So here the dutasteride can be used to treat the benign prostatic hyperplasia. But how this drug acts? This drug is going to inhibit the androgenic activities, thereby it can reduce the prostate enlargement and improve the symptoms of the BPH. This dutasteride can be given as monotherapy. This drug can be used alone. Otherwise, it can be used as a combination therapy. So with which drug it is going to be combined? In the benign prostatic hyperplasia, we have seen that the prostate tissue is going to be enlarged. So one of the drug is the dutasteride, which is going to inhibit the androgenic activities, thereby decrease the prostate growth. But we can also use the other drugs which are going to relax the prostate tissue. So here the dutasteride can be combined with the other drug, tamsulosin. Dutasteride is a 5-alpha reductase inhibitor which inhibits the activation of the testosterone, thereby it inhibits the androgenic activities. And tamsulosin is a alpha-1A blocker, thereby it produces a relaxation of the prostate tissue. In this way, this combination can also be used to treat the benign prostatic hyperplasia. But initially, monotherapy is going to be suggested. And when the monotherapy is unable to control the symptoms of the BPH, then combination therapy can be used. So here, the main action of the dutasteride is on the 5-alpha reductase inhibition. So what is this 5-alpha reductase enzyme? This enzyme is present as two isomeric forms. It is present as a type 1 5-alpha reductase enzyme as well as type 2 5-alpha reductase enzyme. This type 1 isoform is mainly present in the skin and liver, which is responsible for the activation of the androgens at these organs. And type 2 is mainly present on the reproductive tissue. In the male genitalia, this enzyme is responsible for the activation of the testosterone. Now, on which enzyme this dutasteride is going to act? Now, this drug is going to inhibit both type 1 as well as type 2 enzyme. So, it is non-selective for both isoforms. Thereby, it inhibits the androgenic activities at the reproductive tissue, skin as well as liver. On the other hand, another related drug is there, finasteride, which is only inhibiting the type 2 enzyme. In this way, 5-alpha reductase enzyme is very important for activation of the androgens. But how this enzyme is going to produce the active metabolite of the androgens? We know that the androgen in our physiological system is the testosterone. You can see testosterone is a steroid nucleus with delta 4-3-1. That means it is having a double bond at the fourth position and a ketone at the third position. Now the double bond is at the fourth position. If it is saturated, it results in the increased activity. So now this testosterone can undergo the reduction by 5-alpha reductase enzyme. Thereby, it can be converted into another metabolite, dihydrotestosterone, which is commonly known as DHT. Now, you can see that at the fourth and fifth position, there is a saturation. So, this is a simple reduction reaction where the testosterone is converted to dihydrotestosterone, DHT. And this DHT is more potent and the active form of the testosterone. And this enzyme is going to be blocked by dutasteride. Thereby, it inhibits the activity of the testosterone. In order to act on this enzyme, dutasteride should also have some structural similarity. Now let us see the structure of the dutasteride. This is the structure of the dutasteride, and you can observe again it is having the steroidal nucleus, but it is not having a double bond at the fourth position. Instead, it is having a nitrosen at the fourth position. So this drug is a 4-azosteroid, and it is having one double bond at the first and second position and keto group at the third position. And even at the 17th position, it is having an amide which is attached with a phenyl ring with trifluoromethyl substitution. So this is the dutasteride. So dutasteride is having a similar steroidal nucleus like the testosterone, but it is having a nitrosen at the fourth position. This structural similarity is responsible for the action of this drug on the 5-alpha reductase enzyme. Now let us see how it acts. We know that testosterone is one of the important androgens in our physiological system. This testosterone can enter into the cells where it is going to be converted into active form by the 5 alpha reductase enzyme. So now this testosterone is going to be converted into its metabolite DHT, dihydrotestosterone. This dihydrotestosterone can act on the androgen receptors which are present within the cytoplasm. Now once this DHT is going to bind to these androgen receptors, they will undergo the dimerization as well as autophosphorylation. After this dimerization and autophosphorylation, they can enter into the nucleus. Now these receptors are internalized into the nucleus where they are going to act on the DNA to produce a gene transcription, and this gene transcription is followed by protein synthesis. In this way, the dihydrotestosterone can produce few of the proteins which produce the growth of the tissues, and particularly these proteins can increase the growth of the prostate gland, which results in the enlargement of the prostate. In this way, androgens can increase the prostate enlargement, which results in the decreased urinary flow and increased urinary frequency in the patients. So in order to treat the BPH, the actions of the testosterone should be inhibited. And here one of the important enzymes is the 5-alpha reductase enzyme. So this is going to be inhibited by dutasteride. So dutasteride is going to inhibit this 5-alpha reductase enzyme. Thereby it inhibits the androgenic actions on the prostate gland. What are the side effects? All side effects of the dutasteride are related to the reproductive organs. It can produce a breast enlargement and breast tenderness in the patients. And it can also produce impotence as well as ejaculation problems. So failure of ejaculation can be observed with the dutasteride. And it can also produce a loss of libido. Reduced sexual desire is observed with the dutasteride. So all these are the hormonal side effects produced by dutasteride. And apart from this, it can also produce few other side effects like the testicular pain, dizziness, and lightheadedness, which are less observed in the patients. What are the contraindications? The first contraindication is the pregnancy. So this drug is categorized as a category X. So this drug is strictly contraindicated in the pregnancy because the testosterone is going to be converted into dihydrotestosterone by the enzyme 5-alpha reductase enzyme. This dihydrotestosterone DHT is responsible for the development of the male genitalia. So when the dutasteride is given, it can inhibit the 5-alpha reductase enzyme, thereby it inhibits the conversion of the testosterone to the DHT, which results in the inhibition of the development of male genitalia in the male fetus. That's why in the pregnant woman, this drug is strictly contraindicated. Similarly, second one is a childbearing woman. Just like the previous one, this drug can produce some risk to the male fetus. So in the childbearing woman, again, this drug is contraindicated. And dutasteride can also be absorbed through the skin. So that's why the handling of this drug is also very important in the woman. The woman should avoid the contact of the drug directly because the drug can be absorbed through the skin, which can produce some abnormalities. Third one is the pediatric patients. Again, in the pediatric patients, this drug can reduce the growth of the genitalia and reproductive tissues. So it should be contraindicated. And fourth one is the patients with the hypersensitivity. This drug can produce few of the hypersensitivity actions in few of the people. So if any hypersensitivity actions are going to be developed, this drug is contraindicated. What are the drug interactions? The calcium channel blockers like the verapamil and diltiazem, they can reduce the clearance of the dutasteride. Therefore, this drug should be carefully given with these calcium channel blockers. Similarly, dutasteride is metabolized by CYP3A4 enzyme, so it can be converted into metabolites. And strong CYP3A4 inhibitors like the ritonavir can inhibit the metabolism of the dutasteride, thereby it can increase the levels of this drug. So enzyme inhibitors should be carefully given with the dutasteride. How it is given? This drug is given as a capsule at a dose of 0.5 mg. And the dose of this drug again depends on how it is going to be prescribed. If it is used for the monotherapy, the dose is 0.5 mg once daily. If it is given as a combination therapy with alpha blockers, then it can be given at a dose of again 0.5 mg dutasteride and 0.4 mg tamsulosin. Again, this combination given once daily. In this way, dutasteride is one of the drug which can be used as a monotherapy or combination therapy given at a dose of 0.5 mg once daily. And this drug is particularly used to treat the benign prostatic hyperplasia, where this drug inhibits the conversion of the testosterone into the dihydrotestosterone, which is the active form of the androgens. And by inhibition of this enzyme, dutasteride can inhibit the androgenic activities, thereby it can reduce the enlargement of the prostate tissue. In this way, it can relieve the symptoms of the BPH, by reducing the androgenic activities. So that's about the dutasteride. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.